What is up, everybody? Chris Hendrickson here, coming at you with the Hendrickson News. And the animal agriculture industry is at it again with wild and ridiculous laws to stifle innovation, to stifle the reduction of water usage on the planet, to stifle the reduction of greenhouse gases, and to reduce the amount of animal welfare. It is absolutely insane. So this article is coming to you from CNBC. It's titled Burger Impossible: Ranchers Lobby Lawmakers to argue only animal products can be called meat. All right, over the last 10 years, 20 years, we've seen products like almond milk, soy butter, nut cheese. These products introduced into the market, not only are these products amazing at reducing animal welfare, or not reducing animal welfare, but reducing animal suffering, they're also amazing at reducing the environmental impact of our food system. So these products, are wonderful for a variety of reasons, and these industries are trying to stifle that progress by saying that they cannot be called cheese, they cannot be called milk, they cannot be called meat because they don't come from an animal. Like, they're protecting consumers from dangerous and misleading products when everybody knows, you don't milk an almond, you make almond milk. You milk a cow who doesn't want to be milked, who wants to, provide that milk for their baby. Anyways, getting into the article, going in right here at the top bit, beef and farming industry groups have persuaded legislators in more than a dozen states to introduce laws that would make it illegal to use the word meat to describe burgers and sausages that are created from plant-based ingredients or grown in labs. This is a report from the New York Times. And getting into the article, it says right here, it remains to be seen whether the efforts to define meat on a state level or to restrict the sale of plant-based alternatives will succeed. One of the more extreme proposals, which has not yet come up for a vote, quote, would make it a crime to sell lab-grown meat and would bar state funds from being used for research, altogether in Washington state, the Times reported. And this is just really sad because these products that make it easier to produce. They are less harsh on the environment. They taste amazing and provide consumers a wonderful, healthier choice to animal products are being stifled from being entered into the market. So it's extremely discouraging because these companies, the beef industry, they should have been inventing clean meat. They should have been the ones innovating, but since they failed to do so and they rested on their laurels, these new tech companies, these food tech companies, have taken it upon themselves to create a far superior product. And instead of welcoming that change, they're trying to legislate it out of existence or legislate it and slow down the process. It's a pretty, pretty sad situation. Getting to the article again, the lab-grown and plant-based meat substitutes produced by Impossible Foods, Beyond Meat, and other startups have gone mainstream. Now that they can more or less pass for the real thing and are available at your local supermarket or fast food joint, the value of the surging meat substitute market is set to reach $7.5 billion worldwide by 2025. All right, that is an amazing increase in profits for these products because, one, they're great. They taste amazing. They're healthier for you. I'm going on the same points, but they're better for the environment and the customers know it. When the customers know about a better product existing and they know how to get it and it's easy to find, you can get it at Carl's Jr., you can get a Beyond Taco at Del Taco, you can get an Impossible Burger at White Castle. Customers are going to choose that product because it is just simply far superior. The evidence is so clear that red meat and other animal proteins, animal meat, they raise your blood pressure because of the extra fat inside those products. They're associated with heart disease, colorectal cancer, type 2 diabetes, all these diseases that can be prevented that are major causes of death and suffering for humans in the United States. And these plant-based products create a tasty, wonderful alternative for people to try out who want, like me, just to eat a hamburger, but not have the suffering, not have the unintended health consequences, and be good for the environment. I keep harping on those things, but it truly is so important that we take care of our planet, that we innovate and create new technologies that are something our future children are going to be thankful for. Our future children are not going to be thankful that we are clear-cutting the Amazon rainforest to make room for cattle, which are unnecessary to consume in the first place. I understand the historical context and how our country, you know, is founded on cattle ranching and all the history of farmers. And I'm not hating on farmers here whatsoever. Farmers are the backbone of the American food system, and we need to praise them. But what I'm really stressing, what I'm encouraging you to look into, is to really check out these plant-based alternatives, try them out yourself, see if there's something that you like, and just try to reduce your meat consumption. And if you're smart, invest in these technologies. You know, I'm not a financial advisor expert. I'm not giving you financial advice, but I'm just saying, like, if there's a growing industry, why wouldn't you want to invest in it when you know it's going to be big in the future? So continuing into the article, though, in the last few weeks alone, lawmakers in nearly 15 states have introduced legislation to keep these startups from being able to call their products meat. According to the report, meat producers are fearful of falling prey to the dynamic that befell the dairy industry, which tried and failed to keep almond and soy beverages from co-opting the use of the word milk. All right. This is a very lame attempt at the industry to protect their profits. I understand completely where they're coming from. Like, if I was in their situation, I wouldn't be trying these, you know, freshman tactics to try to figure out how to protect profits. I'd be encouraging and buying up these companies so that I can hold on to those profits for the future. And I hope we get to the point where this legislation fails because lawmakers and constituents and citizens see how ridiculous and how fallacious the arguments for these laws are, and really, really adapt and accept and promote and uphold this new technology, which is set to literally revolutionize the world. It is such a beneficial thing, and it really harms me to see just madness like this happening. So anyways, I'm going to link the article in the description. I really appreciate you taking the time to watch. Let me know in the comments what you think about this issue. You know, do you think these lawmakers are right? Should we ban the use of the word meat to describe these products? You know, do you think that they're outrageous like I do? Let me know in the comments. You can follow and join in on the conversation at Hendrickson News on Twitter, and then on, you know, minds.com, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, all those at Hendrickson Media. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a fantastic day wherever you are at.